the fact remains that it's not even a show.
Hello, fellow travelers. It's me, your host, Chris James. This is the Not Even a Show, and I'm back out traveling through time. That's right. Last week, we got 10 points in the World Pranking League, bringing our grand total up to 13 points. Even though we're still 37,000 points behind the leaders, the executives were pleased with the progress and allowed me to use my time machine again. And I used it to head back to the time of the dinosaurs. It's my dinosaur impression. And hopefully the butterfly effect is just like a figure of speech, because I did kill all of the butterflies, about 100,000 butterflies. Anyways, this week we've got a great program for you as the tailgater calls Patrick Netherton, plus a certain bit is back with our favorite host, JJ Mccartney. First, though, we haven't talked to Sebastian Gorka in a few months, but this week, the infamous Sir Prankenstein gave him a call, and for the first time ever, Gorka didn't hang up. No, Gorka bit back. Check it out.
And you will find out much, much more. Let's go to Chris in Richmond, who's got a very interesting question. Chris, line three.
Hey, Dr. Gorka. It's an honor. Wonderful show so far.
Thanks.
I just want to say, you know, in regards to the topic of that Fox News poll on impeachment, which, you know, seems like a bunch of BS to me, but, you know, I have a really quite an intelligent friend who happens to be pretty socially liberal. And, you know, what he says is the biggest thing in conservative politics in 2019 is fear-mongering. You know, whereas on the other hand, I have this rather brilliant conservative friend who's a professor, in fact, and he's adamant that the biggest thing in conservative politics in 2019 is personal responsibility. Now, even though they're both brilliant, I don't tend to agree with either of them in this case, because for me, the biggest thing in conservative politics in 2019 is your head.
Yeah, I knew that was going to be what you...
But why is that amusing?
Why do you think that's funny, Chris? Leave him on, Chris. Is that the best you can do, Chris? I mean, this is the same.
Dr. Gorka,
why do you care?
You're filibustering, Dr. Gorka. What size hat do you wear?
Why do you think what you are doing is amusing to anybody except people with a double-digit IQ like you, Chris?
I'm watching you on the live stream right now.
Uh-huh.
I believe you need a wider angle lens to fit your entire head,
Chris,
in the frame.
It's just not funny. You've got to try harder. That's the best you can do. It's
nobody's satisfied around you. Not your girlfriend, not your sad friends in your basement, not the mother you live with. You've got to try harder, Chris. Thank you, and bye-bye.
Dear, oh dear, and they think they're going to win. We're going to have some fun with Chris and all his friends for the next 390 days and so much longer.
It's so weird. It's the same joke over and over again. It's not funny.
It wasn't funny the first time.
No, of course not.
I thought he was one too.
After our numerous pleas, you guys finally stopped calling JJ on your own, and he returned to the channel. Further than that, though, we decided that the hat bit wasn't working, so it's time to return to our old favorite, the shirt bit. I called him to break the news, and he took it quite well, but the very next day, things were very different. Check it out.
Rocking better shirts than you.
All right, folks, that was Lorraine in Orange County, New York. I'm JJ McCartney. Next caller on the line, hello, you're on the JJ McCartney Show.
Hey, JJ, how are you? Two back-to-back great callers.
Well, thank you. Well, let's not get ahead of ourselves. Well, no, if you're talking about Bob and Lorraine, thank you. Yes, they're wonderful.
How about you? What's going on?
Not too much. I got to say, though, new caller Lorraine, new people watching, maybe you want to say a little thank you to me and the people over at NEAS for getting some new viewers over here. I mean, some people even comment.
Well,
some
no,
people
I'll
comment stuff
you.
In the YouTube.
I'll thank you when you thank me.
Listen, I don't have any animosity toward you as a person. I really don't. As you know, you and I have had many.
That's amazing. Well, I got to say, it's kind of run its course as far as I'm concerned. So I think it's time to probably stop calling you and doing the dumb hat pranks and stuff like that. The reason I say that we're going to stop calling and doing the hat pranks is because it was inevitable, but the shirt bit is back, and it has to be back, and it's coming back, and it's coming back with vengeance.
They're just as dumb as a box of rocks, and not polished rocks either. They're just dumb. They mean, seriously. I have met hot water heaters that had more activity going on than the brain of a Democrat. It's just that simple. Let's go to the phones, IQ, quickly and as polished as we can be here.
Hello, caller. You're on the JJ McCartney Show with IQ Al Rasulli.
Hey there. You hear me?
I can. Who is this?
Oh, great. I just want to talk about how this impeachment thing makes everyone on both sides look terrible. To me, everyone comes out either looking corrupt or like they're just trying to cover their own back. But like, if you really want to cover your back, just put on a shirt.
Yeah, aren't you just clever as you can be?
It's coming back with vengeance.
You know, and honestly, you know, and by the way, you know, these people, the ones that call and say things like that,
they're even stupider
than the Democrats we just explained.
You know, they're trying, and in his little subtle way, IQ, did you notice how he tried to equivocate and say, well, there's really not a right and a wrong. Everybody looks bad in a situation like that. It's not true.
It's absolute. That is one of the biggest fallacies out there. And, of course, leave it to some stupid leftist to come up with that lame argument. That, oh, it makes everybody look bad. This makes everybody look bad. It taints the whole system. No, it doesn't. What this does is it exposes the years of graft and corruption that was the Obama administration, IQ.
There is no doubt about that.
All right, California.
Hello, you're on the JJ McCartney Show. Go ahead.
Hi, this is Claire in Pasadena, originally from Virginia Beach. How are you today?
Doing fine. How are you, Claire?
Good. And I also want to give a hello to IQ. And I just want to say God bless you for talking about this issue. Jeez. Over here in liberal land in California, all the snowflakes, nobody's talking about it, and I'm sure everyone would love to vote for Hillary again.
Well, I mean, they're like they're uninitiated. It's even coming out as college freshmen trying to get into the fraternity. You know what I mean?
So they bend over and they say,
thank you, Hillary, exactly. May I have another? I mean, exactly right. These people are clueless.
It's so different than back home in Virginia. It's just been awful. And please forgive me. I don't want to upset you. I'm a newer listener.
Okay.
And I had a question for you. It's strange that every caller keeps saying shirt, but not every shirt has a collar. Do you ever think about how ironic that is?
Claire, I thought you were one of the unwashed masses out there that, you know, was going to find your way and try and be clever. But in the end...
You're just a lying Jezebel. You're a lying Jezebel. Your parents must be so proud of you. They really must be.
It's coming back with vengeance.
All right, IQ, thank you for your patience as we've worked through some technical issues. We continue to deal with stupidity, rampant stupidity among the telephone-using public. And maybe that should tell somebody something. You know, you talk about the failure of the education system, not only in California, but in the state of Virginia, quite obviously as well.
Shame on you, you Jezebel.
We'll be back.
The JJ McCartney Show.
The phone lines are now closed. Please call back when the phone lines are open.
Aw, another snowflake. Another snowflake bites the dust. Yep. See how they run? Another caller on the line. Hello, you're on the JJ McCartney Show.
The shirt bit is...
Ah, yeah, you're funny. Okay, Minnesota, hello, you're on the JJ McCartney Show.
The shirt...
Yeah. See, you don't last long around here. You don't. You
really don't even amount to a pimple on an elephant's butt.
Although, the smell is, I'm sure, quite similar.
We love shirts. We try to pray. We tried hats. It didn't take. So now we're back where we were. Calling up and saying shirt. It takes a lot of tries.
Patrick Netherton and his call screener Rogers are two fun-loving guys who love sports, and they've started getting calls almost every week from our pal Tailgater, who also loves sports but mostly just loves getting drunk. And they've become really, really good friends, and it's nice to hear their conversations. Check it out.
318-657-0426. Let's go to the phone lines at 318-320-1130. Gator making an appearance for us.
What's up, Gator?
Hey, Patty Cake. I didn't know Rogers was his first name.
Yeah, it's not his last name, man.
What the hell? I mean, you got to admit. Hey, you got to admit. I'm not crazy here when I say that's mainly would be a last name.
I mean, most of the time, yeah, but what did you think his first name was?
I thought it was like Pickle.
Pickle Rogers. That would be an odd name for sure.
But Patrick, you don't understand, man. My mind's all twisted up. I'm always coming up with wild, twisted ideas.
He's a motherfucking tailgater.
I feel like anyways, I understand your mind's pretty twisted, Gator.
Yeah, that's true. You would understand that, being that you're my closest friend. And will be my best man at my wedding.
Oh, you need to send me an invitation.
No, I don't have a girlfriend.
Oh, okay. But when it does happen at some point.
It's not if but when, my friend. If but when.
Yeah, look, I'm sure there's a woman out there willing to be fooled.
In the meantime, I need you to send me a jar of your piss.
I don't think I have that available. Sorry, can't do that.
Well, of course you don't have to. You don't have it available. You gotta make it available. Send it over. They're piss testing us at the movie theater. I work at a movie theater.
Yeah.
Uh huh.
I mean, really? They drug test at a movie theater? You have to be clean to work at a movie theater? Come on, how is it to rip tickets?
At this one, I'm not ripping tickets. I'm cleaning the seats off. You wouldn't believe how nasty some of those things are. Some of the nasty stuff people are doing in movie theaters.
I know that
people are doing nasty stuff in these theater seats. You want to know how I know, Patrick? Because I'm the one doing it.
Oh, there you go. All right, Gator.
He's a motherfucking J.O. Gator.
Appreciate you, man.
I don't know what the hell's going on with that guy.
Oh, man.
Well, everybody, that's the end. What was that? Oh, it was a dinosaur that went by. Remember that I'm with the dinosaurs? Anyways, thanks so much for watching. If you want to watch a little bit more, head over to patreon.com/noteven a show. We've got a fantastic call about our friend Jesse Farrar, as well as some other goodies for you if you love to laugh and have fun. Other than that, go pick up a shirt. We've got the link below in the description. Get your own nice shirt. We're going to be making a collage of nice shirt photos, and you send them in, and we're going to have fun together. Don't call JJ on your own, please. Just because he's back doesn't mean you can call him on your own. Bye. I love you. See ya. Bye.